tip 72, I'm going to talk about something that we get probably on 99% of our conversations with our first-time homebuyers, and it's going to be about closing costs. Okay, so closing costs, especially for our VA loan buyers, it is a zero-down product. So what does that mean? You don't have to bring any money for a down payment. But in order to close any loan, even with like refinancing, FHA loans, and a conventional loan, there are still these things called closing costs. And the closing cost is what it takes in order to actually do the servicing end of it. So you've got transfer stamps, you've got prepaids, so you got taxes and insurance, you get all kinds of different fees that go into closing costs. On average, and this is just an average, it's about 3% of the purchase price. So on a $200,000 home, the closing costs are gonna be on average about $6,000. So as a buyer coming in and saying, hey, Mr. and Mrs. Seller, I'm gonna offer you $200,000, but I'm gonna need $6,000 in closing cost assistance. What you need to understand as a buyer, and the first time this is happening, is that actually a seller has closing costs. Believe it or not, they have about 3% of closing costs, and then they also have the real estate professional fees, also known as commissions. So on average, a seller is gonna have anywhere between 8% and 9% in closing cost fees. Plus, if you're asking them for your closing costs as a buyer, think about that 3% now goes to their 8% or 9%. So that can be anywhere between 11 and 12% that is gonna cost the seller in order to sell the home to you. So that's why we always bring up, hey, buyers, sellers both have closing costs. Buyers is on average about 3%. Sellers on average is anywhere between 8% and 9% depending on the commission fees. I hope that helps. That was tip 72.